We have studied yesterday Ohm's law and the relation between the current and drift velocity. Now today we are going to discuss or establish the Ohm's law in vector form. Ohm's law in vector form. Let us consider a conductor, rather you can say this is metallic conductor of length L and cross sectional area A. Again, we consider that there is free electrons inside the conductor and N is the number of free electrons per unit. A is the cross-sectional area of the conductor, L is the length of the conductor, N is the number of free electron per unit volume. Number of free electron per unit volume, and then again M is the mass of the electron and E is the electronic charge of the electronic charge, right? Now if we apply a potential difference across this conductor, let V is the potential difference across this conductor, then there will be an electric field of intensity E equals to V by L. E equals to V by L throughout the conductor. Here V is the potential difference across the conductor and therefore the electric field E equals to V by L. And due to this electric field, the free electron inside the conductor will be drifted. Let Vd is the drift velocity. Then we know two things. One, we have earlier established a relation between current and drift velocity. If current I through the conductor, then current I will be equal to N E A into V. N is the number of free electron per unit volume, E is the electronic charge, A is the cross-sectional area of the conductor, and Vd is the drift velocity. And again, we have also established a relation or established a equation or a expression for drift velocity Vd, which is equal to E tau divided by A. E tau divided by A. But tau is the relaxation time, which is the average time between two successive collisions. Now you can write I is equal to N E A into V D is E into capital E into tau divided by M, right? Or we can write I is equal to N E square A tau by M into E equals to V by L. E equals to V by L. Or we may write I by V is equal to L E square A tau by M into L. Right? I by V is equal to this. Or you can write V by L. Or you can write V by I is equal to M into L divided by M square A into tau. from Ohm's law, we know that I is proportional to V or V is proportional to I. Now see here, I by V, which is equal to N square A tau by M into L. Now N is the number of free electron per unit volume, is constant. L is the length of the conductor, constant. A is the cross section area of the conductor, constant. Tau is relaxation time, that is also constant. And E is electronic charge, M is mass of the electron. All these are constants for a particular conductor. Then you can write this is equal to constant. That means V by I is equal constant, and which is equal to R. We have already started that the ratio between the potential difference and current through the conductor is called the resistance of the conductor. Therefore, this can be treated as a resistance. Therefore, this expression will be equal to resistance R, resistance of the conductor, that is R. Therefore, you can write R is equal to M into A divided by L is square tau into A. L is square tau into A, which can be compared with R equals to rho L by, because we have already discussed that R is equal to rho L by, where rho is for the resistivity of the conductor, L is the length of the conductor, and A is the cross sectional area of the conductor. Therefore, from here you can write resistivity of the conductor rho is equal to M by L square tau. Or we can write conductivity sigma, which is equal to 1 by resistivity, is equal to N square tau by M. Sigma, that is conductivity of the conductor, is equal to N square tau by L. Now, see here, I by V is equal to N square tau by M into A by L. N square tau A divided by M into A. Now put here. Now replace this by sigma. Then you can write sigma A by L. Or we can write I by A equals sigma into V by L. Sigma into V by L. Now current per unit area is called the current density. Therefore, J is equal to sigma into V by L is the electric field. Now, this is a vector quantity, this is also a vector quantity. Then we can write J equals to sigma into E. This is called the Ohm's law in vector form. We have started here. This is Ohm's law, right? Now, this Ohm's law can be written as J is equal to sigma E, where J is the current density and E is the applied electric field. Therefore, J is equal to sigma E. Sigma is the conductivity of the conductor. This is the Ohm's law in vector form.